My name is Jasmine K, and I am a member of Prep for Prep Contingent 38. As I stand here today, I feel the weight of history behind me. I feel the support of thousands come before me, and I see the future in the faces here in front of me. The past couple of years have been harsh. In the pandemic, the world has struggled with hospitals overflowing, isolation, and a race to find a vaccine. As our lives shifted to an online platform, I'm sure all of us heard the words, uncertain and unprecedented times. Uncertain and unprecedented seems to sum up all of our academic journeys, including my own. My parents are both immigrants from India. When they immigrated, they had no certainty of their future. All they had was their work ethic and the word yes to every opportunity. When they brought me into this world, they gave me everything they could and beyond. To them, everything meant an amazing education and the luxury to find joy. My mother would teach me advanced math out of borrowed library books. My father, after working for about 16 hours, would drive me to JFK to watch the airplanes take off as a personal air show. They have taught me the meaning of hard work and, more importantly, happiness. My mother's tutoring would help move me from a local underfunded public school into a specialized gifted and talented school. I loved that school. I had great friends to play with at every recess, was learning how to program through online courses from Johns Hopkins, and started to grow past 4'6". At that age, that's the best you could hope for. Then one night in October changed my life. I had an unfortunate accident and suffered third-degree burns. It took the ambulance over 2 hours to get me to the nearest burn center. The lack of medical access I faced that night would leave a permanent reminder at how inadequate the healthcare is in my community. That experience would later lead to my decision to study medicine in college and beyond. After weeks of treatment at the New York Presbyterian Hospital, I learned a new fact. Third-degree burns leave permanent scars. Scars tend to be seen with a negative connotation, something ugly, something to be hidden from the world. For years, that is what I believed. Caught up in this pessimistic sentiment, I couldn't see the beauty of the accident, how those scars were reminders of the pain that I overcame. Rather, I abandoned my parents' teaching about joy and obsessively adopted their work ethic, taking every single opportunity to be busier. If I kept working, I had a semblance of normalcy, like nothing was wrong, like I had no scars. My permanent scars became my greatest motivator to absorb every single detail of knowledge that I could. 2 weeks after I got back to school, my teacher, Ms. Alperstein, impressed with my resilience, recommended me to Prep for Prep. I had no clue what the program was. I just remembered my parents' advice to take every opportunity and immediately got on board with it. Eventually, I would come to realize that prep had changed the trajectory of my life. And so, I made it through the preparatory component and began poly prep in 7th grade. Poly, with its plethora of extracurriculars and advanced classes, gave me the opportunity to learn anything I could dream of, proving to my parents that they made the correct decision to immigrate. Even in just 7th grade, I was able to participate in Girls Who Code and Science Olympiads. Yet, the social adjustment was difficult. I was an unprecedented marker. I was thrust into a community in which no one looked like me, no one shared experiences similar to mine. I tried to ignore these changes until they became so prevalent that I could no longer ignore them. The constant racism was accompanied with words that scabbed, scarred, and reopened until I could no longer continue taking part in this cycle. This is when I learned the value of PrEP's post-placement program. My PrEP counselor, Justin Hysand, who is also a PrEP alum, was a figure of strength and a shoulder to lean on whenever I felt that my hard work was pointless. He constantly advised me to be the change that I desired. I took his advice to heart and joined speech and debate. When I joined a team, I was an incredibly shy sophomore, insecure in my own voice. Debate taught me how to speak with conviction and clarity, to critique public policy, but most importantly, to learn to advocate for myself and others. In just a couple of years of participation, I was ranked among some of the top debaters in the country, and I'm still top five in the state. And though winning was fun, I really just saw debate tournaments as practice for the real world. After some practice rounds, I felt ready to advocate for important change in my own community. The first change I knew I had to create was to make Poly a safer space for BIPOC students. I created affinity groups, such as the South Asian Affinity, advocated for diversifying English and history curriculums, and mentored incoming ninth grade students. This year, I helped organize Poly's first Diwali celebration. It was the first time I could ever recall Poly doing anything to recognize my heritage. I walked around campus and saw other students drawing chalk rangolis, eagerly getting in line for henna, and enjoying sticky gulab jamuns. By learning and giving back to my community, I found joy in my life again. This joy was amplified by Prep's Aspects of Leadership's workshops. With Mr. O'Leary's guidance, I cherished the time as a way to reconnect with my contingent. I gained strength due to similarities in our stories, inspiration from the efforts of Prep students to bring change, and pride through their achievements. I don't know what we will encounter in the next chapter of our lives, but I know that we are ready. We are ready in large part thanks to the investment that Prep for Prep has made in our lives. And with the world in disrepair, Prep is more important than ever. Frederick Douglass argued that it's easier to build strong children than to repair broken men. Prep does just that. We will be the leaders of tomorrow, and we will not simply repair a broken world. We will build a stronger one. Prep enters its next chapter with the aim of innovation, and it is our responsibility as Prep alumni to innovate as well, to do the unprecedented, and to be unrelenting in our pursuit. This fall, I'll be taking the next step in my journey by attending Johns Hopkins University in their biomedical engineering program. I will be the first in my family to go to college. The Prep for Prep class of 2022 has had one of the most unorthodox high school experiences, but we have made it. Please give a round of applause for all graduating students and to their families for their unwavering support.